Sorry.
All of us have ups and downs, positive things, negative things in life, things that you lose that can hurt you a lot. That's part of life, I get it. But the more experience I have, the more knowledge I get. And when those hard times come, I've been taught to go to that place that you love and that place that makes you happy. The great thing about this profession is not having all the tools, but to realize and understand the ones that you were missing. And work hours and days on trying to develop them to the best of your abilities.
If you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you wanna be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that and that ain't you. You're better than that.
I don't count my sit-ups. I only start counting when it starts hurting. When I feel pain, that's when I start counting because that's when it really counts. That's what makes you a champion. That's the way it is with everything. No pain, no gain.
Sometimes I look out of the studio and imagine playing baseball, football or hockey, all the sports I played through my teenage years and with my brother and friends. And imagine how it would be like if I was still playing those. Just sometimes. Just because I know it would be easier than ballet. It's so hard.
Two.
Sometimes it's hard for me to even concentrate at the bar or in class. Just because I'm thinking constantly of every correction that I have been told. It's in my mind, striving to improve on them constantly. And thinking where I would be in 5 years or more. Or is this the day where I get injured for good? One jump, one awkward landing, sound of a pop in my Achilles or knee. I can't help these things going through my mind, sometimes just quick flashes, but it goes through my mind.
Now you're gonna have to go through hell, worse than any nightmare that you ever dreamed. In the end, I know you'll be the one standing. You know what you gotta do.
We have so many rules in life about everything. I say break the rules, not the law, but break the rules. It is impossible to be a maverick or a true original if you're too well behaved and don't want to break the rules. You have to think outside the box. That's what I believe. After all, what is the point of being on this earth if all you want to do is be liked by everyone and avoid trouble? The only way that I ever got any place was the breaking some of the rules. And reaching out and helping people will bring you more satisfaction than anything else you've ever done.
Smile, bro.
enough. I never wanted to lose a competition because I didn't work hard enough. I always believe leaving no stone unturned.
Alright, I'm gonna try seven.
Because the minute I do it, that means that I'm the first one that has done it. So pay no attention to the people that say it can't be done. You can't always win, but don't be afraid of making decisions. You can't be paralyzed by fear or failure, or you will never push yourself. You keep pushing because you believe in yourself and in your vision. And you know that it is the right thing to do when success will come, so don't be afraid to fail.
I knew, somehow, that I had to stay alive, somehow, even though there was no reason to hope. So that's what I did. I stayed alive. I kept breathing, and one day that logic was proven all wrong because the tide came in and gave me a sail. And now here I am. Back. And I've lost her all over again. I'm so sorry, but I don't have Kelly. I'm so grateful that she was with me on that island. But I know what I have to do now. I have to keep breathing. Because tomorrow the sun will rise. Who knows what the tide could bring.
Dig deep down and ask yourselves, who do you want to be? Not what, but who. And I'm talking about not what your parents and teachers want you to be, but you. I'm talking about figuring out for yourselves what makes you happy, no matter how crazy it may sound to the people. I spent a lot of time by myself so I could figure out and listen to what is inside my heart and inside my head.
Joseph Gatti, and I've been a ballet dancer for over 20 years now. This career can be so unfair, so fun, it can be frustrating, so hard at times. But one important thing I've learned is to not sacrifice the love and happiness of this beautiful art form just for a big name of a company, or you should be going somewhere just because other people think that's where you should be at. You have to love this beautiful and short career to the very last day, and I can say that I'm closest to that happiness than ever before.
Going back to the start.